Hello everyone, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are. And my name is Prophet Stephen Larolotu from International Christian Association. Please join me on every Thursday between 2 and 3 o'clock, you know, to hear what God is having for us at this time, the message of the coming back of our Lord Jesus Christ the second time. This message is very needful at this time to prepare for the coming back of our Lord Jesus Christ. It's very essential, very important that yet you tell somebody to come and join you as you come. Don't come alone because it is very, very special and necessary. It shall be well with you as you do so in the power of our Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you.
Wonderful story of love. So you are far away. Wonderful story of love. Still we go
today. Wonderful story of love. Yes, the love of our Lord Jesus Christ towards humanity. He died on the cross of Calvary for everyone not to die the second time internally. That is the message we are bringing again today. I want to say good morning to someone in the morning. If you're in the afternoon, good afternoon. If your time is evening, good evening. I pray for someone today that shall be well with you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
That yet the grace of God shall be made manifest concerning you.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Answer Amen. To prayer shall be given unto you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. The Amen. Desire that your good desire shall be accomplished in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You that is sick, receive your healing.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. Yes,
Amen.
I say it again. You are sick, receive your healing. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, who
Amen.
Died on the cross of Calvary.
Amen.
In any way, things are not working well in you, in your life, in your household, in your family. Let healing enter in there now in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Healing spiritually, physically, financially, materially, in every areas of your life where you need God to attend to you. Receive his hand of fellowship today in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Help of destiny shall be raised for you in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
For answering our prayers this day.
Thank you, Lord.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Thank you, Lord.
This is the National Christian Association, as it is on the screen. So many of us who have been part of this program before now, you know, we do tell you it's not a church program. By name, Association of Those That Believe in God, that trusted in God, that knows the will of God, that want to even know the will of God. Those are the people that God is talking to at this time. On this platform we stand. Yes, International Christian Association. You know, it's a platform where Jesus Christ wants us to go and talk about his coming back the second time. To go and talk to this word of this day that, yes, he's coming back the second time, as he has said. And most especially, he wants us to go and talk about what, you know, heaven requires from everyone, every man, every woman, every sister and brother that is glamoring about the kingdom of God, talking about the kingdom of God. Somebody who believe that, yes, after this place, there is another place to conjure together to see the face of the Lord. And Jesus Christ said, go and talk about it to my people. That this is the reason why we are here again today. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is not a church matter. It's not about either you are a Christian, you are a Muslim, you are a believer, you are atheist, whatever might be your religion, go and tell my people that, yes, after this place, there's another home. Hallelujah.
Amen.
What you need to do, what I need to do, what we need to observe to enter into that place is what we are here for again today. There are so many people that are not in church. They believe that, yes, the kingdom of God is sure. And yes, what do they need to do is what we are here for. If you want to know how far we have gone, why don't you visit YouTube and search for Prophet Olotu? By the grace of God, you find almost everything there. As we're in the studio now, we are on Facebook. You know, you can go along with us on that channel too. And you know, if you have somebody in Nigeria, Africa, you want him or her, you know, to be part of this message of the kingdom of God at this time, the message that is scarce, tell that person to join us on Legend Platform TV on subscription in Nigeria. You know, it will be part of that program. As we are in the studio now, you can join us, you know, on What Faith TV on channel 589 Sky. You can beckon to someone around you far to be part of this program. It's a message for this time. A message that is scarce. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Most especially that is necessary for someone to know that there's going to be hellfire at the last day, the time of judgment, hellfire, and the kingdom of God. Where will be your choice? Where will be my choice is what God is talking about now for everyone to hear, to know about. And it shall be well with you as you listen in Jesus' name.
Amen.
My name is Prophet Stephen Larolotu. The same man of God be coming together. We are here again today. No other person, evangelist, Raphael Omota Ajiboye. God bless you, sir.
Amen. Amen.
For another glorious time, we are journeying before the Lord, as we do, as we normally say. It is not by making of humanity, it is by the making of the Almighty God, who spared us to a time like this, who gave us this assignment to do for him. And nobody can do anything except he receive it from above, he's given from above. That's the reason why we have come. And before we move on, I will ask the man of God to pray for us. The minister, over to you, sir.
The Lord of God, the yes. Almighty Father.
Yes.
Wonderful Father, we give you thanks.
Thank you, Father.
The maker of everything, we give all the praise.
Yes.
The one that say, I am the beginning and the last, we give all the honor.
Yes.
We adore you.
Yes, Daddy.
Now, Lord, we want you to speak out by your mouth. Through our mouth to your people today.
Amen.
And then your word today deliver.
Amen.
Set people free.
Amen.
From any form of bondages.
Amen.
Either of ignorance.
Amen.
Of foolishness.
Amen.
Or of the world.
Amen.
So people deliver.
Amen.
And let there be joy.
Amen.
Let there be happiness.
Amen.
Let there be gladness.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
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 In Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Once again, you are welcome. Anywhere he went, he was doing good. All my day in the life of when the cripples saw him, they started walking. Anywhere he went, my Lord was doing good. Anywhere he goes, anywhere he went, he was doing good. Oh my dear, in the labor, he said, when the cripples saw him, they started walking. Anywhere he went, our Lord is doing good. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He will perform wonders in your life again today.
Amen.
By his word.
Amen.
By his wonders.
Amen.
By his miracle.
Amen.
If you believe it, say big amen to him. By the word of God, you shall be healed.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
What is it that we are having again for the people of God? It's no other message than what God has given to us to talk about for a while. The school of life. And today is the 78th episode. Until we hear him again. The school of life. The life he gave to man in the Garden of Eden. That somehow we lost to the hand of Satan. And which Jesus Christ brought back to us by his coming back, to us here on earth, to die on the cross of Calvary. He taught us what God wanted in heaven before he go back. And he promised that he's coming back again. He wants us to now go back to that, you know, school of thought of then, where he wants us to do things like him, the way he wants things to be done. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And what is that he gave us of reason to talk about? He said, go and talk to the ears of Abraham. We'll be talking about this now for a while too. Go and talk about the ears of Abraham. Those that believe that, yes, they are children of Abraham by religion, by faith, by birth. That what they are doing at this time is not what he expected of them. They are just fighting over, I am the fourth, I'm the heirs of Abraham, I am the first son of Abraham, whereas what God expected from them is not what God is seeing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And they are clamoring for the kingdom of God. God said, go and talk to the Christians and the Islamic, you know, believers. Those who are saying to themselves, yes, I am the son of Abraham. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I am a child of Jesus Christ. And God even said, go and talk to everyone that will be hearing you. That, yes, I am a God of all flesh. Go and talk to them. That, you know, instead of there to talk about God now, it's about argument and fighting about religion that will not take them to the kingdom of God, that they have left so many things undone. Go and talk about it. See, the time is this time we are now. It's a time to look for the lost. Everyone that have moved away from the path of God, path of righteousness, laid down precedent of God, principles of God, to their own mind, to their own thing. Go and talk to them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God said, go and talk to my people. Everyone under heaven created the image of God are the people of God. He said, go and tell my people you are not a man or people of God because you are in church, because you are a bishop and apostle, and somebody who is in the mosque or somebody in the street is not a son of God. No. He said, no, go and tell my people, I am a God of all flesh. Therefore, you have the word of God in common. Everyone has the word of God in common. The commandment in common. The commandment that God has given to you as a Christian is not different to that of a Muslim man or a pagan, an idol worshiper. He's coming to judge every one of us on that same law he gave to man at the last day. Go and talk to my people. They have the same word in common to abide with. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He said, go and talk to the sleepers. Everyone that is sleeping, to wake up. A sleeper, you know, wake up from your slumbering, from your sleeping. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know you are no more doing the things of God you started with. You are no more on the path of righteousness. You are a sleeper. You are still falling to know all those things God doesn't want. You have slept away. Wake up. Because the kingdom of God is coming to ask questions for man. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God said, tell people that they should be aware of what they think within themselves. That your outward appearance cannot move God. Has to do with God. Maybe somebody will say, what is he talking about? Yes, I know what you are talking about. Say, if somebody, you know, come naked to the household of God, will God not be bothered? Yeah, it's different to walk this case. It's the same thing. Your outward appearance that is making you big, that yes, I am a man, you know what you put on, that's your regalia. I am a pope, that's your regalia. I am an apostle, I am a prophet, that's your, you know, garment. That is making you different to the people around you. That is making you puffing. See, that can never move God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
In the other way around, what you wear can make you, you know, a servant of God, or can make you, you know, an enemy of God. If what you are wearing is not what God wanted, what you are wearing is just opening, you know, you are walking naked in the community. And you know what that can do easily? Yeah, as a woman, You know, everywhere you're supposed to cover is where you are, you know, you are making open to people. And you think, yeah, because you are this, might not help you to the kingdom of God. That is what somebody wants to hear. That yes, what you wear at times might determine either you are going to be a child of God or an enemy of God. If it's not, an adequate wear before the Lord. So go and tell my people, everyone will account for his, for his character here. The character you exhibited here while you are not here, you shall be accounted for it. I will account for it. Every one of us, young and old, every human being shall appear before the throne of grace at the last day. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I mean, let us say grace. It's here we need grace now. Judgment, rather. Amen. Because grace will stop here. Then the seat of judgment will appear there. Then what we do here will determine, will cycle us that day. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And Jesus Christ is the Savior of the world. Go and tell it to people. Let them hear. You are a Muslim. You are a Christian. You are a pagan. You are an herbalist. Your God is moon. You don't even believe that it's God. Jesus Christ is the Savior of the whole world. Why is this a Savior? He came to teach us to know more about what God wanted from us. So for you and I not to put our hands into evil, to save our mind, our heart from taking evil, doing evil, carrying out evil. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Jesus is the Savior of the whole world. And he says commandments about God and, and your fellow brethren. The commandment God gave to you is about God and your fellow brethren and your love towards God and towards your fellow brethren. Hallelujah. Amen. It's a message we need at this time after the COVID that we are seeing, that is ravaging around us now. That we are still praying to God to let it go. I remember when he started with us in year 2020, everything he said about COVID that will happen came to pass. As is the one in charge that want to teach us lessons, he says go to battle economy, everything that will happen. So you think we are clever, but thank God for the grace that we are joining in him. So what does he say to us in the book of Genesis chapter 26? From verse 1. There was another famine as we have it now on the land.
Beside the early war during the time of Abraham.
Inconsistency in the land. Things are not working well anymore in the land. Trouble is increasing in the land. Terrible things are happening in the land. Like it was in the days of Abraham, the father of our fathers. If you are a child of Abraham, you believe that, yes, you are a tribe of Abraham, heirs of Abraham. Hear what your father Abraham did. If you are not doing them, be asking yourself questions. Am I going to enter to the kingdom of God that I know that will come at the last day? What does he say for that?
Isaac went to Abimelech, king of Philistines.
Yes.
At Gera.
Yes.
The Lord had appeared to Isaac and said.
The Lord appeared to him and said,
do not go to Egypt.
As God is still appearing to so many people today. I do tell people there's no one God cannot appear to. Appearing of God's name, but you being a Christian or being a Muslim who knows how to fast or somebody who knows how to consult something. When God wants to appear to you, it doesn't matter who you are. He appears, appearance is about his nature to anyone you want to talk to. Anyone who wants to see him, who needed him. Your thinking might want to see God. What you are saying might want to see God. He appeared to Isaac in Gerar. What does he say to him, sir?
Do not go to Egypt.
Do not go to Egypt.
Stay in this land.
Stay in this place. Where I tell you to stay. Some people now, when they mention Egypt, they thought it's an evil land. No. What God was saying to him is the same word that we are in here. Somebody who is in London who wants to travel to France for a living, and God is checking him. That is the same thing. You want to travel to Egypt, as he don't go there. What does, why does he say you should not go there?
Live here.
Live here.
And I will be with you.
I will be with you.
And bless you.
I will bless you.
I am going to give.
Because God is the one who knows everyone. He created you into your mother's womb. Forget about your religion now. It's a God who mentors your life. He knows what he wants to do with you. But what does he say to Isaac?
I'm going to give all this territory to
you. I am going to give this territory unto you.
And to your descendants.
Though it is a famine land, nothing is coming good there. But I will provide what you need here for you. That is what God is saying to somebody today. That is the one in charge of your life. That provision you wanted, is the one that can do it for you, that can give it unto you. Nobody receives anything except it's given from above. Anything you receive outside God will never last. It will end any trouble in calamity. Yeah, what does he say to him?
I will keep the promise I made with your father.
I will keep Abraham. The promise I made with your father Abraham.
I will give you as many descendants as there are stars in
the sky. If you are a child of Abraham, lineage of Abraham, there was a covenant that God had with Abraham that was passed on through till we get to this age that we are in. We are getting there. What does he say to him?
Descendants are there are stars in the sky.
Yes.
And I will give them all this territory.
And I will give them all this territory.
All the nations will ask me to bless them as I have blessed your
children. All the nations will ask me to bless them.
As you bless your.
To bless them as I have blessed Abraham and your descendants. Because through you as my child, I will bless others. If there's any gift that God has given unto you, as you are watching me, to those that will watch hereafter, if there's any gift God has given to you, that money that is in your hand is not for you alone. That position is for somebody else to enjoy what he cannot do that God has handed over into your hand. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You are a prime minister. That position is for somebody under your government, your governance to enjoy life. You are a president. You are a leader of a family, of a house. You are in a big position, good position. That position is for somebody who, you know, who is not as big as you are to enjoy what you are enjoying. He doesn't have that capacity to do what you are doing, to get to where he has gone to, or where you have gone to. That position is for you to make somebody laugh. He said to Isaac, through you, people will enjoy my grace, my covenant. If you are a son of Abraham, heirs of Abraham, people around you cannot enjoy the grace God has given to you. God might ask you a question that today. That position is not to make you puff above others. Is to make you appreciate the grace that God has given to you, to know how to do that thing, to know how to enjoy that position that God has given to you. He said something for that to him.
I will bless you.
I will bless you.
Because Abraham obeyed me.
Because Abraham obeyed me.
And kept all my laws and commandments.
Kept all my laws and my commandments.
So Isaac lived at Gerar.
That is why the commandment of the Lord is about God and people around you. God said, I bless Abraham, your father, even while I gave him that covenant, because he obeyed my laws and my commandment. He's want to enjoy the promises of God for you now. How far do you want to go by the laws of the Lord and the commandment of God, for that's your nature, where you are a leader. The reason why some leaders or some countries will never enjoy the deeds of God is because of what they are doing, what is in their hands. The evil that God doesn't want you to do, that is what you see carry out in your country. Your men are doing it. That is why there's no peace. Peace is now scarce in our world of today. It's increasing every day. Problem is increasing every day because the commanded of the Lord, the commandment of the Lord, the laws of the Lord is fading away from our community, our behaviors. He says, Isaac, if you want to enjoy the promise I am saying to you now, you must relate your life with that of your father. Heirs of Abraham, how far are you traveling in the laws that your father Abraham, enjoyed with God then? Yes, you are sons and daughters of Abraham. It is not by religion. It is by what you do as a child of the Lord. It doesn't matter what you call yourself. You call yourself a child of God, slave of God, servant of God. You say God is not even your father. What does he say for that to him, sir?
So Isaac lived at Gerar.
He lived in that place.
When the men there asked about his wife.
When they asked about his wife.
He said that she was his sister.
Yes.
He will not admit that she was his wife.
That doesn't even go down. He says he lived in that place. He obeyed the voice of the Lord. He did not allow what was going on in that city to overrule the commandment, the laws of the Lord for him. How far have you traveled with the commandment and obedience to the will of God for your life? And you are calling yourself heirs of Abraham. You are calling yourself sons and daughters of God. You are calling yourself the most apostle, the most reverend. You are calling yourself the most imam of the land. Without you, the president cannot talk. Without you, the prime minister will never speak. That position that you cover, how far have you used it as a child of God? Because question will happen over all the characters we exhibited here at the last day. Say, go and tell my people. What does he say for that, sir?
Okay. Abimelech warned all the people.
Yes.
Anyone who will cheat this man.
Yes.
Or his wife.
Yes.
Will be put to death.
Uh-huh.
Isaac sowed.
Isaac now sowed.
Sowed seed in that land.
That is where I'm going. He sowed in that year, in that land.
And that year,
in the midst of that farmer, he sowed. In the midst of that, farming, he carried out business. Because he has listened to the word of the Lord. He wants to see what God will do after his word. What does he say will happen, sir?
And that year, he harvested 100 times.
He harvested 100 times hundreds.
As much
increase,
as he has sown.
As much as he has sown.
Because the Lord bless him.
Because the Lord bless him.
He continued to prosper and became.
He continued to prosper.
A very rich man.
He became a very rich man.
Because he had many heads of sheep and cattle and many servants.
That's okay, sir. It's a long story, but I want us to stop there. The Bible says he obeyed the Lord. And what he never thought would happen began to happen. How far have you listened to the voice of the Lord? How far do you want to obey the voice of the Lord? And you don't obey the Lord, and you want calmness to come to your countrymen, you want peace in your nation, it can never happen. You want peace in your family lineage, as a father, as a mother, as a husband. You didn't follow the commandment of the Lord for your life. And we are getting there now. And you want to enjoy God. It can never be. Hallelujah. Amen. So what does he say to us in the book of Exodus, chapter 20, from verse 1? Heirs of Abraham, hear what God is saying to you now. It's not about fighting argument. It's about how far you have taken the word of the Lord for God. How far have you walked in the commandment of God? Enough of the argument that we are using to pull ourselves down, sir, of recent, even till last week. I see here, I have some people still talking about that man of God in Nigeria who died, T.B. Joshua. Many are still talking about either he's a bad prophet. He was using magic, you know, black power. And you are a man of God. Is that your sermon? Is that your sermon? Your sermon is to teach people what they need to do. Why this man was here or not? Most of them did challenge him. They didn't tell us what he was using. You didn't stop him from using that power. Jesus Christ came, he stopped everyone that were using all those power. He stopped them from using the power. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is not the message of the Lord from the people of God. They are still talking about somebody that is dead. Instead of that, to preach the gospel that Jesus Christ wanted for those that were following all those bad gods to understand the will of God for their lives at the last day. Hallelujah.
Mm-hmm.
While he was here, you did preach to him that prophet, man of God, the power you are using is not good. It will end you a fair fire. Hallelujah. Say, go and tell my people, that is not what the kingdom of God is all about. It's about go and talk to my people what I required for the kingdom of God that will come. What does he say to them, sir?
God spoke.
God spoke.
And these were his words.
And these are the words of God.
I am the Lord your
God. I am the Lord your God.
Who brought you out
God of all flesh. God of all flesh. Hallelujah. He said, I am the Lord that brought you out of the land of Egypt.
Where you are?
Out of trouble. Whoever is in trouble now, you know, Egypt is a place of calamity for some people in those days. That was what God made then. But now that Jesus Christ has now come, he doesn't want to base anything for the things of the physical. He made everything spiritual. Want us to understand this and this and this and this. It's not about the Egypt that we go today. So many people, they don't want to go to Egypt. But when they want to go to Holy Land, they go to Sinai. Is Sinai not Egypt? We must know this for ourselves. And when Jesus Christ was given battle, Jesus Christ, God said, carry him to the land of Egypt. So that is not what God is saying to us. He said to them, I brought you out of trouble.
Where you were slaves.
Where you are slaved.
Worship.
There are so many of us today, we are slaves in the hands of our tormentors. If you are one of those in the hands of a tormentor, you need to be delivered. Be delivered in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Say, I brought you out of calamity from the hand of tormentors. What does he say to them?
Worship no God but me.
Worship no God but me.
Do not make for yourselves.
Do not make yourself any image. Under heavens.
On earth. Or in the water under the earth.
You know when Satan was in heaven, and the archangel, he said he wanted to lift his own throne above the throne of God. That was what brought him down. God said, don't lift up any other God over me. Are you a child of Abraham? Heirs of Abraham. And you know those things that you consulted, everything you still pray to, everything you are still using as power. God said, the kingdom of God will not be for you because you trusted another God beside God. And God said, I am a jealous God. He will show us his jealousy that day. So he says, you shall not bow down unto them.
Do not bow down to any idol or worship it.
Do not bow down unto any idol or worship them. You are a worshiper of idol. You are worshiping bull. You are worshiping water. You are worshiping, you know, in my country, God of thunder, God of iron. They were human beings in nature of man, formed to be gods. You are not a child of God. You are not a son of Abraham, either son of Christ Jesus Christ. You are still someone of devil. He said, thou shalt not worship any other god. That is why he said to us, the commandment he has given to us is very essential.
Because I am the Lord your God.
I am the Lord your God.
I tolerate no rivals.
I don't tolerate rivals. So you still know where you go. After you pray, after your fasting and prayer, you know what you keep into your pocket. Where you want to travel, that is your God. That little candle you put in your pocket, that tira you hide it, those small things that you are still using with God. We now give you the kingdom of God that day. Say, go and tell my people, you are still a pope, you are still a priest, you are a prophet. You know what you condone as your power. You know what you consulted. We see them here and there now. You know what to drink. You know what to drink. You know the power you look for you to occupy that position that will not make you a carrier of the kingdom of God that day. He said, what does he say for that, sir?
I bring punishment on those who hate me.
I will bring punishment on those that hate me.
And on their descendants down to the third and fourth generation.
On their descendants to the third and fourth generation.
But I
so that is why you must teach your children how to know the way of the Lord, to serve God alone. It's because many can. The reason why God told me, the reason why we have, most of our leaders in Nigeria, where I come from, Africa, cannot do good, is because of what they consulted before they get to power of leadership. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because when you don't believe in God, you don't depend on God, you depend on somebody, that's your boss, is your brother. When they get to a position and you think it's just your brother put it there, you will not see God. They know where they have gone. So God said, many of them, they know what they have done, who they kill, the blood they shed, before they get to that position. So when they get to that position, they can never give you enjoyment because they'll be telling you, go and do what I did too. If you want to get money from me, if you want to enjoy water from me, you need light, go and do what I do too, to come and sit on my seat. And they will enjoy life here. My God. But at the last day, you are going to see the kind of enjoyment they will enjoy here or not. That will not prove them to be children of God. What does he say?
But I show my love to thousands.
I show my love to thousands.
Of generations.
Of generations.
Of those who love me.
Of those that love my commandment.
And obey my laws.
And obey my laws. I love them. So when you obey the commandment of the Lord to let us, he loves you. You'll be walking towards the kingdom of God you are talking about. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. Jesus Christ, you know, he knows what to do to call you. It doesn't matter. Only I think in the book of Mark, he made us know that when you are walking the commandment of the Lord, you are walking in the path of the kingdom of God. Jesus Christ was the one that says it. Hallelujah.
Mm-hmm.
So you call yourself the heirs of Abraham. You are not in church. Try to walk in the commandment of God. He knows what to do. It's in the Bible. Because I go and tell my people. God sees, he oversees everything. He knows when you are walking well. He knows what to do to pull you aside. We spoke about that man last week who was an imam. He told us, it is now that I gave my life to Jesus that I knew that we have done well. I mean, we have done evil. We've carried out evil. In that position, people are still doing it today. So, it is not where you worship. There are so many Christians that will not see God. There are Muslims that will see God. It's why in the world yesterday, you are an herbalist yesterday, you are not preaching the good gospel of the Lord. Carry on. You are welcome home. You know, begin to talk about people that you left behind that will still be expecting to come to the kingdom of God. Don't condemn them. God doesn't want us to condemn ourselves. He wants us to show ourselves the way to righteousness. What does he say for that?
Do not use my name.
Do not use my name.
For evil purposes.
For evil purposes.
For I, the Lord,
as we are doing today, using the name of God, the name of Jesus Christ, for evil purposes. You know, fighting here and there. Mine is the best. Yours is the best. Lying against one another. I want us to talk about the commandment today. I don't want to go into stories. What does he say further, sir?
For I, the Lord your God, will punish anyone who misuses my name.
I, the Lord God, will punish whoever misuses my name.
Observe the Sabbath and keep
it holy. You are misusing the name of the Lord. In error, omission. He said it is terrible for the last day. And you know you are lying and you are swearing. You are misusing the name of the Lord. You are in the court of law. You know what you do there. You know somebody is not guilty. And you made him guilty. And the one that is guilty, you made him free. Oh my God. It is dangerous for the kingdom that will come. Hallelujah. That's your friend that is judge here. The most respected judge will not stand for you, will not stand for me. The most respected, you know, barrister or lawyer internationally will not stand for you. You'll be alone. Your wife will have no say. Your husband will have no say that day of judgment with you. It's you alone. It's me alone. But what you do will determine where you to stand that day. If you are doing well, you know, if somebody, herbalist doesn't serve another God, he will not be an herbalist. You are a bull worshiper. The moment you don't worship that bull, you are no more an enemy of God. That's what he said to us. You can be in church and still be an enemy of God. You can be an imam and still be an enemy of God. If what is in your hand is not clean, that's what he said to you. What does he say for that, sir?
Observe the Sabbath.
Observe the Sabbath of the Lord and keep holy. It. The day of the Lord, keep it holy.
You have 6 days in which to
somebody want to ask me, but we have so many people that, you know, some people, they made this Saturday, some people Sunday, some Friday, some. Your day of, make every day of your life the day of the Lord. Every day of your life, because you don't know the one that Lord will accept from you, just make every day of your life holy, according to what you want to hear now. If you go to church on Sunday and you made it holy and you battle Monday to Sunday, Saturday, you will miss the kingdom of God. Make every day of your life, 24 hours every day, a day of the Lord. Hello, good afternoon, caller. Hello, caller. Okay.
Hello, good morning.
Good morning. Good
morning. My name is Gail. Asking you to pray with me. I'm having chest pain. I'm having spiritual attack.
Just lay your hands on your chest.
Yes.
Everlasting Jesus, we thank you. Lord Jesus, who does all wonders and miracles. Lord, I send that your power, your Holy Spirit power,
amen,
into the heart of your daughter, into where she's placing her hands. The heavy pain there disappear in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I command peace, amen, to enter into your being.
Amen.
In the mighty, amen, name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And I ask that the desire of your heart, your desire shall be given unto you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Every spiritual, amen, attack be seized in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
You know, at your free time, go and read Psalm 37. Mm-hmm. Just try and read that psalm for about 3 times. If you can do it today, fine. Don't let anything disturb you. You want to invite, mm-hmm, God into your being, into your life. And thank God, mm-hmm, for everything that God wants to do. I see that chest pain is gone. God bless you. Yes, what does he say? Come again. Okay, he's gone. What does he say, sir?
You have 6 days in which to do your work.
He says you have 6 days in which you need to do your work.
But the seventh day is a day of rest.
It's a day of rest.
Dedicated to me.
Dedicated to me.
On that day, no one is to walk.
No one is to walk.
Neither you. Your children.
Your slaves.
Your animals. Nor the foreigners.
The foreigners.
Who live in your country. In 6 days, I, the Lord, made the earth, the sky, the sea, and everything in them. But on the seventh
day,
I rested. That is why
I, the Lord,
bless the Sabbath, and made it holy.
Hallelujah.
Respect.
I'm coming, sir. God wants you to rest. And in resting, you have time, you know, for God in your spirit, man. Hallelujah. Things are changing in our society today. But make every day the days of the Lord, so that you will not lose in any form. That when God shall come that day, you say, okay, Lord, you know, you are doing well with me. Okay, yes, I can see you are doing well. But God wants to rest. Look for a day of rest for the Lord in your closet, in your life, in your household. Make it a day for God. Why every day will be a day of holiness in your life? Find a day to rest with God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We can see nowadays, you know, in our country where we are now, England, we had the story before that on Sunday, you don't open shops.
Mm.
On Sunday, no job, no work. But thank God for the new dawn. Every day has become a day of money. Hallelujah. What does he say for that, sir?
Respect your father and your mother. So that you may live a long time in the land that I am giving
Mommy,
you.
Mommy, daddy, sister, brother. It is a commandment of God to respect your father and your mother. Respect is about honoring them. It doesn't matter what they do to you. Honor them. When you slap your mother, you slap your father. It may affect your kingdom of God. It's a commandment of God that honor your father and your mother. You want to ask me, what if my mother didn't respect me as a child? God says, respect your father and your mother. And what God is saying to us, you know, if I can satisfy, is that you as a child, you must not take your mother to bed. You must not take the wife of your father to bed. Vice versa. So when you respect them, even to totality of your life, everything about them, you must not share with them. What does he say for that, sir? Quickly.
Do not commit murder. Do not commit adultery.
Do not commit murder. Thou shalt not kill. Hey, you know how many people you have killed, and you know how many you are still killing with your position, with your mouth, with everything you have. That's your power you have. You will pay for it one day, and we pay for it one day. We shall all pay for it one day. Because of your mouth, somebody lost his job at job. You will pay for it one day. Except you repent and say, God, I'm sorry. It's a commandment of God that God will put before us that day. No wonder when Jesus Christ came, we are still going to talk about it one time. He says, whatever you will not want anybody to do unto you, don't do it to them. What does he say for that, sir?
Do not commit adultery. Do not steal.
I'm coming, sir. Adultery is about, you know, you are not right for marriage. And you want to start to, you know, go out with so many ladies, so many guys. God said, you mess up yourself because the day, when the day of righteousness shall come before you, you will have, you know, move out of the will of the Lord. Your bed must be holy. If you cannot keep yourself holy, don't go into it before the Lord. Thou shalt not fornicate. Don't go to adultery. Hallelujah. What does this say for that, sir?
Do not steal. Do not accuse anyone falsely.
Do not steal. What does not belong to you, don't take it. Do not accuse somebody falsely. Let us hear it very well. commandment of God. Somebody did do something. You lie against him or her. Till that person was punished, you shall pay for it. Because the commandment of God is about God and your fellow brethren. So what does he say for that, sir?
Do not desire another man's house.
Do not desire another man's house.
Do not desire his wife.
What belongs to another person, another man, another woman, don't desire it. Look for your own.
His slaves.
Somebody is married, has his own house. You as a man, married man, you are high. I mean, his own wife too. The husband of that person, you are high. Oh my God. God said that will strike you, is going to ask you a question that day. So what does he say for that?
Or anything else that he owns.
Anything that belongs to him.
Where the people had the thunder and
that
the trumpet.
Job that is not yours, don't take it over from that person. That house that somebody built, you know, we have it, it's happening in our community where we came from. It's even happening here. You know, that house was not, you don't own that house with your husband or your wife. He got the house before, you know, before he got married to you. At the moment he or she married to you, you know, you are just walking behind to take that property from him or her.
And kick him out.
You pay for it. You say it's a style in abroad. You pay for it. Because you will hurt that person. What you are doing to hurt somebody shall ask you a question. So what does he say for us?
When the people heard the thunder and the trumpet blast and saw the lightning and the smoking mountain.
Now when they hear hear the voice of the Lord and when God speak, it come with lightning. Light means purity, clarity of God.
The temple with fear stood a long way off. They said to Moses, if you speak to us,
yes,
we will listen.
Uh-huh.
But we are afraid that if God speaks to us, we will die.
That's okay, sir. That is what Jesus Christ came to do for us. That, hey, you know, they didn't want to see the face of the Lord God. The day Moses went to see the face of the Lord God, he came down. They could not look unto his eye. That was the reason why God sent Jesus here. So that we can see his face. He can befriend us. It is not good to see the eye. God said, Moses, you cannot see my face. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank God that he sent Holy Spirit to us now to come and dine and wine with us. If God should come to our level, we'll be able to withstand him.
Moses replied,
Do not be afraid. Don't be afraid.
God has only come to test you and make you keep on obeying him. So that you will not sin.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He doesn't want us to sin against his commandment. Say, go and tell my people, my kingdom that is coming, we ask questions. At the last day, there will be two places, hellfire and the kingdom of God. Don't say, has it been there before? Yes, it's because God is still speaking to everyone that I want to speak to every day. He said it to us, and we have come to deliver it. It's not a matter of church or being a mosque worshiper or somebody, you know, in the community. God wants us to follow his commandment. When you follow the commandment of God, then you follow the path of righteousness. You will know God. You will serve God as he wanted. Every one of us become a Christian then. Christ-like person, God-minded person. Hallelujah. All of us in the world. Hey, you are a Muslim yesterday. Hey, I'm a Christian today. You are a Habali yesterday. When we all follow the law of the Lord, we become brothers and brother and sister, following the same path of righteousness. Religion will not separate you. That was why I said, it's only the same word of God that he has given to every one of us. If you want to be prayed for today, I ask that the Spirit of God will pray for you.
Amen.
By the power in the name of Jesus Christ. And if you have not given your life to Jesus Christ, please do it now. To tell people, giving your life to Jesus Christ is about, you know, giving yourself to the word that Jesus Christ brought here. You can't say, I confess Jesus Christ, and you didn't obey what he gave to you. It will not work. But when you first key yourself to what he has said, then you can say, oh God, you'll be following the path of righteousness to the kingdom to come. If Jesus tarries, by the grace of God, we shall appear at the same time next week to come and share whatever God is giving to us again. What are we talking about this time? It's a time that people need the word of God more than before, that the kingdom of God is at hand, that the years of Abraham should leave behind the fight that is going on now and begin to walk in the path of righteousness till Jesus shall come. From me and from the man of God, we are saying, God bless you.
Well, thank you.
Hello, everyone. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are. And my name is Prophet Stephen Larolotu from International Christian Association. Please join me on every Thursday between 2 and 3 o'clock, you know, to hear what God is having for us at this time, the message of the coming back of our Lord Jesus Christ the second time. This message is very needful at this time to prepare for the coming back of our Lord Jesus Christ. It's very essential, very important that yet you tell somebody to come and join you as you come. Don't come alone, because it is very, very special and necessary. We shall be well with you as you do so, in the power of our Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you.